Hello, today discuss about lab diagnosis of parasitic disease. We all know that laboratory diagnosis plays a vital role in diagnosis of parasitic infection, and the following diagnostic technique can be used for diagnosis of parasitic infection: macroscopic method or gross examination of a specimen, microscopic method, then there are culture methods to grow the parasite in the lab. Certain immunodiagnostic methods are available for antigen and antibody detection against parasites, and there are molecular methods to detect their nucleic acid molecule. Various specimens collected for diagnosis of parasitic infection are feces, perianal swab, duodenal contents, blood. We can take urine, sputum, bone marrow, or biopsy from spleen, liver, and lymph node can be taken for diagnosis of parasitic infections. How to collect the stool specimen? A stool specimen is collected in wide mouth container, and contamination with urine, water, and disinfectant should be avoided. And at least 3 stool samples are collected on alternate day for diagnosis of intestinal parasitic diseases. And semi-formed stool should be examined within 60 minutes after collection, whereas liquid stool can be examined within half an hour after collection, and blood sample can be taken by finger prick from lobe of an ear, or EDTA blood can be used. If delay in transport of fecal specimen is there, then it should be kept at room temperature. It should never be incubated or it should never be frozen prior to the microscopic examination, although sometime we can add preservative in order to maintain morphology of parasitic cyst and egg, and the preservative used can be formal saline. This is the layout how stool examination is done: macroscopic or gross examination for consistency, color, and composition. Microscopic examination can be done with help of saline smear or iodine smear, or otherwise we can have concentration technique in if the number of eggs or cyst is low in the sample. And the other methods of stool examination are cellophane tape and ova quantitation techniques are there. Macroscopic examination or gross examination is done to see whether the stool is having mucoid or bloody consistency. This is found in case of dysentery, whether this is caused by amoeba or by intestinal cystosome. Color, if the color of a stool is dark red, this is indicative of upper GIT bleeding, whereas bright red stool is suggestive of bleeding from lower GIT. Frothy, pale, offensive stool is found in case of Giardia infection. In liquid stool, trophozoites are usually found, whereas in semi-formed stool, both trophozoite as well as cyst are found. Sometime we are able to see the adult parasite as such in the stool sample, like Entrobius and Ascaris. And the proglotid of tapeworm, they can also be found in the stool sample at the bottom of the container. Microscopic examination of a stool is done in order to find out the ova and cyst of different parasite. For that, we prepare a wet film on saline mount one side and on other side iodine mount, and with help of a wooden stick or match stick, we can take a stool sample. After proper mixing, we can mix it with the normal saline drop and iodine drop, then put the cover slip and examine under microscope. First we can do low power microscopy, after that high power microscopy is done in order to identify the ova, trophozoite, and cyst. This is how to make the smear. We can take a drop of saline, mix the stool sample in that, and put cover slip over that. On other side we can have Lugol's iodine, then add a stool sample in that, mixing is done, and put cover slip. On same slide, both of the preparation can also be done. This saline smear is helpful in finding the eggs of various parasites and to find out the trophozoite motility, which is found in case of amoeba and flagellate. Whereas iodine smear is helpful for morphological details of various cysts of parasite. So this is already I told you that saline mount is helpful in finding out the trophozoite and cyst of protozoa and egg of helminths, and motility can be better seen in case of saline mount. Whether they are trophozoite or larvae of parasite, motility is better seen in saline mount. Iodine mount, nuclear details of the cyst, egg and larvae becomes clear in case of iodine mount. Whereas the disadvantage of iodine mount is that this immobilizes and kills the parasite, hence motility of trophozoite we can't appreciate in the iodine mount. And bile stained property, some eggs are bile stained one, that again can't be appreciated properly in iodine mount. Then one more method of examination of egg or parasite is scotch cellulose adhesive tape method. In this, 3 inch of tape is held adhesive side out over the wooden blade, then adhesive surface of tape is pressed against the perineal skin, and then we place this adhesive tape on the slide for examination. This is how the adhesive tape is used in order to collect the perianal egg deposited here, and thereafter we can put it over the smear and examine under microscope. NIH swab can again be helpful in case of Entrobius egg, because they are deposited at perianal and perineal skin in the night, so they can be taken with the help of NIH swab, and then microscopy can be done. This is how NIH swab and how this is taken up. Then there are permanent stained smear like iron hematoxylin, trichrome stain and modified acid fast stain for diagnosis of various parasitic ova and cyst. This is a picture showing iron hematoxylin stain. This is trophozoite of Entamoeba coli and this is cyst of Entamoeba coli, as more than 4 nuclei are present. Entamoeba histolytica trophozoite in trichrome stain, they look like this. Modified acid fast staining is done for identification of Cryptosporidium parvum, Isospora and Microsporidium, and these are the parasites which are commonly found in immunocompromised patients. So special staining is done, and thereafter picture will be like this. The background will be blue whereas the parasite will be pinkish red in color. This is modified ZN staining which is done for Cryptosporidium, Microsporidium and Isospora. These are Isospora belly. They look like this. Then egg of Paragonimus can be seen in the sputum sample. Urine examination can be done for trophozoites of Trichomonas. They look like this, Trichomonas vaginalis. We identify them with their motility. Then blood specimen can also be examined for parasite, and this is helpful in case of Plasmodium, Trypanosoma, Leishmania, Babesia, then various filaria parasite like Wuchereria bonecrofti, Brucia malai and Mansonella. And a drop of EDTA blood can be taken over the clean glass slide. We can put cover slip over it and we can examine under microscope for large motile exoerythrocytic parasites such as microfilaria. This is how microfilaria look like in wet film of blood. These are the microfilaria. Then we can prepare thin blood film for examination, and thin blood film can be prepared and thereafter staining can be done in order to identify the malaria parasite. Thick blood film can also be prepared. If number of parasite is low, we can see them in the thick blood film. This is thin smear and this is thick. Dehemoglobinization of thick smear is done and thereafter staining is done. How we stain the peripheral blood film? By Leishman stain, GEMSA stain or by GSB stain. And how the parasite look like? This is Plasmodium vivax. And this is gametocyte of Plasmodium falciparum. These are RBC and this is malaria parasite. This one and this one. GSB staining can also be done in the field for identification of malaria parasite. how the malaria parasite look like in GSB stain, you can see the ring forms inside the RBC. These are trophozoites of malaria parasite. And GIMSA staining can be done, and for that fixation of smear is required. And how microfilaria they look like in GIMSA staining, and this is the peripheral blood film. You can see the arrangement of nuclei properly. Then there are certain blood concentration technique also, like a stool concentration, and these are microhematocrit, triple centrifugation, buffy coat, knot, membrane filtration and gradient centrifugation technique. If the number of parasite is low and we are not able to identify them in direct blood film, then we have to go for concentration method of blood for identification and for diagnosis of parasite. Culture. We can cultivate the parasite in the laboratory, and cultures available are axenic culture. This is a pure culture without any bacterial associate. Genic culture. Parasites are grown along with unknown microbe. Monoaxenic culture, parasite are grown with single bacterium. Polyaxenic, if we are using multiple bacteria in order to grow the parasite. Then there is triple N culture media for Leishmania and Trypanosoma. RPMI 1640 is used for Plasmodium, and Diamonds medium is used in order to grow the Giardia lamblia. Then there are certain serological technique also for antigen and antibody detection against various parasite, but these are not very sensitive and specific as far as parasites are concerned. Then molecular assays are available in form of PCR for diagnosis of leishmaniasis, toxoplasmosis and Chagas disease. This is a picture showing hydrated cyst. This is caused by echinococcus granulosis, and sometimes surgery. From surgery department we get such type of a specimen along with the organ. So these are hydrated cyst. And such type of picture showing LD bodies we can see in a patient of Kala Azar, in which biopsy of spleen and liver has been taken, or sometime we can see them in the PBF also. In Bikaner region we are having oriental sore or cutaneous leishmaniasis. In that we prepare impression smear, stain them by GIMSA, and then we will be able to visualize these amastigote forms of Leishmania parasite, and these are popularly known as LD body after the name of discoverer Leishman and Donovan, along with these mononuclear cells. We can see them. They may be intracellular also, or they may be extracellular.